Welcome once again to another episode of Women on Fire. It is so nice to get together once again. Today's subject, it is a very exciting subject. And it is about asking, believing. So for those that are watching this program for the first time, relax, sit down, make yourself a cup of tea, and receive whatsoever the Lord has to give you. Because I believe God has something in store for you. Welcome, girls. It's so nice to get together again. Amazing subject. The subject of asking, believing. I don't know, why would God give us a subject called asking, believing? What would be the reason why he is putting the believing next to the asking? Any suggestion, any experiences in your life?
Can I just start by saying this while we were talking earlier on, I believe God has given me these things as we do it. Can I just share that with everyone?
Sure.
And yes, just let me get to it. When you come about talking about ask and believing, I think this really is the message before we talk deeper into it. And in Isaiah 66, it says, "Heaven is my throne and the earth is my footstool. Where is the house that you will build me?" And build me is God. God, that means God. "And where is the place of my rest?" And God's resting place. Didn't the Bible say we are the temple of the Holy Spirit?
Amen.
So God dwells in us. And Jesus, you know, the earth is his footstool and heaven is his throne. When you say, then I'll give you another verse. It says, yeah, just give me a second. I think this is utterly important. And further on, and Isaiah 60, a second part of verse 18, it says, "But you shall call your wall salvation and your gates praise." Now, how is it related to the previous verse I'm talking about? Because heaven is God's throne. And earlier on, Sister Elizabeth said, when Jesus been baptized, opened heaven.
Yes.
Heaven's
yes.
Open. Now it comes up, heaven is my throne. Then earth is footstool. So we Christians standing on footstool, but we need to harness heaven to come down.
Amen.
What? And Jesus say, "Where is the temple you built me?" So Jesus can take rest. When heaven come down, we are at rest. So they say, how to bring heaven down? Your wall, your salvation is your wall. What does the wall do? Wall is to protecting you inside, hide you in. When the wall collapse, all gone, right? And to say the gate is praise. When what the gate does, open. It opens. What? How do you do it? You get into the presence of God, you need to open. Open with what? Praise.
Amen.
Thanksgiving. Amen. And they say the gates are what? The gates, the door of our eyes be open, the nose to smell the fragrance of fruit of Christ, the incense that rise up. We speak good things, open.
Amen.
Ears open to the Holy Spirit. Right? This is saying to everyone, get attuned, in tune instead. So when we align that, when heaven come down, we ask and believe.
Exactly.
Isn't it? That comes to one word that really come that's supporting this, I want to say, and that's the Lord's Prayer. It says in Luke 11, and it says this, "Our Father in heaven," why? We talk about heaven, right? "Hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, and your will be done," God's will be done, "on earth as it is in heaven. So give us today a daily bread and forgive us sins, for we also forgive everyone who is indebted to us. And do not lead us into temptation and deliver us from evil."
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Yes, amen. Well, obviously the Lord is giving you this revelation when you were waiting for on the Lord. Yes. That is wonderful. And this is a key to be in tune with God. Wait upon the Lord. Receive from Him. And let that word that comes into your heart change. Now, what I was hearing you, I was asking the Holy Spirit, okay, what is the relation of this vision to asking and believing? And I believe that what God is saying is in the words that you were reading and how you related the revelation that God gave you, He's talking about the eyes being open to the spirit realm, to the heavenly realm, the ears being open to the spirit and heavenly realm, the nose sense to be open to the heavenly realm, the lips and so on. So God is saying, I like to open your senses to be sensitive to what I say through those senses. For instance, many believers might be saying, yeah, well, it all is very nice that you girls say that, but I can't hear, I can't see in the spirit realm, I can't smell anything except the food I cook and all these things, all the touch, I can't sense the touch of God. Don't be discouraged. We've all been there, right? We've all been there. It's like a baby's being born, even though he has the senses, cannot recognize it.
Actually, Sister Stella, I once asked the Lord, you know, in my quiet time, and the Holy Spirit said that the believing part is very important, you know, because when you ask, you have to believe, because that belief connects you to the kingdom of God.
Amen.
You know? And when you believe, it is saying you are trusting your heavenly Father.
Amen.
You know, and it is a very powerful thing that is happening in the spirit when you choose to believe, when you ask and you believe. So after that time, I realized that in everything, you know, when we ask, we believe, we are saying, God, I trust you, you know. I trust you with all my heart that you're going to answer my prayers. Yes.
Amen. How timely you're all speaking.
Can I just
testimony? Lynn. Yes, please.
Quite a recent one. Sister Katrin and Angeli just know my problem is my older son. And I've been praying for him. And he able to really to walk his God and to change his behavior and attitude, because he's just sort of carrying very rebellious attitude.
Yes.
And I've just been praying for last few years, but I haven't seen his change. I mean, there's so slow that it just really frustrates me. And so I just cry out to God, God, you have a promise to me, and it will change and transform me, but I can't see. But the Holy Spirit told me that don't look around what is happening right now. Don't give too much attention what is happening right now, but believe what all the word God has given to me concerning my child, and the anchor it, and also the declare it.
Amen.
And speak
Amen.
To the truth, I speak to the future, he said.
Amen.
And then he showed me the vision, and I'm rock climbing, so I just threw the rope to the higher position and anchored it, and then I just climbing, and with persevering, and declaring, and believing, and then Holy Spirit came and supported me, so I able to see fulfillment of promises. So that is, for me, it's like, as you said, just, as you ask, and they believe, and that we will see the result in God's timing, in God's term.
Amen. Yes. How wonderful, as you are speaking, what comes into my heart is, and the scriptures come as well, and is everything in believing of what we ask and declaring. Because the things of heaven are what seems unseen to the natural realm, to the natural eyes. We all have to develop into the spirit to be able to be opened in our eyes, in our ears, and our senses, be open to the spirit realm. But the Word of God tells us that the spirit realm is the unseen, and God made what it can be seen, this whole world and all the galaxies and all the stars. He made them from that which is not seen. So, in other words, God is talking. You might not see yet in this natural realm, but you're declaring it and seeing it in your heart, in the spirit realm. And this is the projection of declaring unto being that which is not yet. God did that through Christ.
That's right.
Yes.
God spoke. The Holy Spirit was hovering over the earth. He said, let there be light. And the Holy Spirit went forth, yes, and light was. So the light wasn't there, but it was in the heart of God. He was in the mind of God. So he spoke forth what he believed, what he wanted, what he wanted to create and how he wanted to create it. I believe that. And what happens? The Holy Spirit moves.
That's right.
And there was light. Okay. Now, if we are meant to be made in His image, as He said, we are, then what God puts in our heart regarding our family, regarding our spiritual future, regarding many things that God puts in our heart, we take all of that in our imaginations. In our hearts, we take hold of what images God has given us. That's what I call imagination, where God put images. Sometimes the imagination is polluted. We need to sanctify it and consecrate it to God. So it is only the pedestal where God speaks and gives images. Must do that. Once that is done, God gives us images. And like you say, we take hold of that and speak unto being in the future, that which is not here yet. And this is the creative power of God. This is moving like Jesus did. Jesus said, be whole, be made whole. So what happened? Oh, I was reading today the story of the lady that the son died. And I heard a preaching about this son that died and how Jesus raised him because he felt compassion for her. This is not the opportunity to speak about it, but it's amazing. This guy have been dead for days, embalmed and so on. I mean, to embalm at that time, they take the entrails out, the brain out. And Jesus says, be made whole. So what did that made? He spoke a new brain, new entrails into that body. And all those particles that make an organ became together within this man. This is the power that God is wanting us to enter in. Not because we are so smart, but because He is inside of us. And if we humble ourselves and ask, believing, He will release it to us. And when you were talking, Courtney, when you were talking about the senses and all that, I think we should pray together about this and ask, Lord, for everyone that doesn't smell in the Spirit, cannot smell in the Spirit, anyone that cannot hear in the Spirit, cannot see in the Spirit yet.
Yes, right.
It is for us. But if it hasn't been released yet, we have to ask, believing that it is for us. Believing that God already, God is ready for us. We need to ask, knowing that is ours to have. We need to ask God, reveal what's hindering me from moving in that power. What is hindering me? What's stopping me? What is blocking me from hearing, from seeing, and all that, all the senses of the Spirit? Amen.
Amen.
Shall we pray? Lynn, can you lead us?
Heavenly Father, I just thank you so much, Lord Father God, the resurrection power and that you have given to us, Lord. You said that, Lord Father, we can do greater things what you've done, Lord. What a wonderful God we serve, Lord Father God. And to do that, Lord Father God, we need Holy Spirit and who dwells on us, Lord Father God, and flow out like a fountain, Lord Father God. And Lord Jesus, I just pray, Lord Father God, for all of us, and just let us and open our spiritual eyes, open our spiritual ears, and be able to see what you're doing, Lord. Be able to hear what you're saying, Lord. And especially, Lord Father, just give us your heart, Lord Father God. So with your heart and with your mind, and just what you're saying, Lord Father God, be able to do greater things what you have done on earth, Lord Father God. So we don't want to be feeble and your children, but we want to be strong and be courageous, Lord, because we know that, Lord, and the resurrection power and that within us, Lord, is waiting for us and to use, Lord Father God, for your kingdom's sake, for your glory, Lord Father. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Oh, Father, we thank you and we praise you for who you are. And for these revelations and these words, Lord Father,
yes.
You are a heavenly Father. You are a daddy from heaven, Lord. And heaven is our home, Lord God. So I pray that a special power of faith of Christ, Lord, will rest upon everyone that is listening to this program, Lord God. Lord, that everyone will have that ability given by you, that grace given by you, that faith of Christ given by you, Lord God, to ask, Lord, believing that what we are asking, it is given already from heaven, Lord. I pray that everyone that is listening to this program will be endowed with the power and the ability and the favor to get to home at any time they need to be refreshed, my Lord. Everyone will be able to experience heaven. Go up and down. To be refreshed, to be endowed with gifts, Lord. To be strengthened, to receive more revelations, Lord. I pray, Lord God, that you will begin to release the ability and the faith for all of us, Lord God. To ask that our senses be in tune with your Holy Spirit, Lord God. That we may be able to know what you are saying by the smells we smell, Lord. To know what your Spirit is saying by the voices we hear, the voice of God. To know, Lord God, the revelations of heaven, by eyes being open, that we may be able to see home and to be involved, that all is in home, Lord. At any time we need, Lord Jesus, that our hearts be open. I pray for everyone that is watching and all of us, Lord, that whatsoever is blocking our senses from being in tune with your Holy Spirit, in tune of what the Spirit of God is saying, in tune with your voice, Lord, in tune with the presence of Christ, that those walls may fall down like Jericho walls. Oh, I sense there's been deliverance for many, even right now. There has been deliverance. And many walls have fallen down. Hallelujah. And Father, I pray, Lord God, that everyone be made sensitive, Lord, like a pure bride. All the blockages, Father, be exposed and destroyed. In the name of Jesus, there will be a clear contact with heaven, Lord God. Clear contact with heaven. And Father, I pray in Jesus' name, Lord, the blessings of heaven be upon everyone that is listening to this program, Lord. That everyone be endowed with the ability to ask, believing, Lord, sometimes our faith is small, but we pray that you give everybody the revelation to take hold of the faith of Christ, unfailing faith of Christ. Ah, hallelujah. There is more deliverance. Just people just being delivered right now.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Even more people are being delivered right now. Right now. Even more people are being delivered right now. Right now. Right now. The senses, your senses, your natural senses are being united with the spiritual senses and they're being put in tune. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. We give you all the glory, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Well, how wonderful the way God works things. These unexpected things. So, asking, believing.
Yes.
Have you been ever in a position that you ask, but deep inside you don't believe? Come on, we can be real, you know? Hey, there's people out there that are experiencing this and they, you know, they think they're the only ones. Oh, look at these girls are so super spiritually, but we I can't do that. No,
yes.
We've all been here and there, right? I have been. I have asked desperately, but still not believing. You know, it's a condition of heart.
Yes.
Now,
yes.
Tell me your testimonies. Well, what you have experienced.
Can I share my testimony?
Okay.
My son was in the school, and his school fees are quite expensive. And we were in a state where we were not able to pay his school fees anymore. And he was in the important years in his life for HSC. So we prayed because the school said, if you don't pay the school fees, you know, your son cannot continue. But we didn't want to tell him. And we just prayed and my husband decided to fast, you know. And then the Lord said to me, do you believe your son's school fees is paid? So I wrote it down. I said, yes, Father, but there was a little element of doubt. And he spoke again. Your son, this time he was very, no, in no uncertain terms. Your son's school fees has been paid. Wow, I ran down the stairs. I said, Eddie, do you believe Elijah's school fees has been paid? He said, yes. The moment he said yes, the telephone rang and the school business manager said, Mrs. Wongso, I have such wonderful news for you. Someone is wanting to pay your son's school fees for 2 years. I
Glory to
couldn't
God.
Believe
Hallelujah.
It. I praise God
Hallelujah.
For that. And I...
Amen. Thank you so much, Angeline. That is an emotional thing we all go through when we experience that we, like a little child, ask God believing. And just we all to the end of this program. But I have one scripture to close and to encourage ourselves and everyone who's listening. And it's in Proverbs 22, 17 to 19. And it says this, listen. Submit to the words of the wise and apply your mind to knowledge. For it will be pleasant if you keep them in your mind, believing them. Believing them. Your lips then will be accustomed to confessing them. So that you trust. Your belief, your reliance, your support, and your confidence may be only in the Lord. I have made known these things to you today, even to you. And the Lord's word will set us free from every doubt, from every unbelief, for everything we learned in the world. Dear beloved, we are close to the end. And we're going to close this episode. But I would like us to take hold of these words and even ask God that He give us the grace to believe. That all unbelief be removed. I know He's done a great work today. So with thanksgiving, we commit every word given into the hands of the living God, our hearts and our faith, for Him to use as He desires. But for now, precious one, we look forward to see you next time. Next week, bring your friends, bring your relatives. It is wonderful fellowshipping with you and being blessed by the Word of God. Thank you so much for joining us. Until we meet again, God bless you.